there, Edward.
Oh, Jenny, can I fix you a martini?
No. How about lime soda?
Lime soda on St. Patrick's Day?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what kind of an Irish lass are you, anyway?
One who's half German and half Italian. But I do think that this green soda is a nice touch, don't you?
Yeah, anything you do is a nice touch, mm-hmm. And I'm happy to be your grandfather. Well, it's a little early for the cocktail hour, but considering the holiday and the company, to your marriage.
Ah, thank you. You know, I am sorry that Ned's not here, but I'm very happy to have you to myself.
Well, I've been wanting a moment alone with you, too.
Why do I get the feeling that I'm about to get some grandfatherly advice?
Well, as long as you live, I want you to be a member of this family.
Those were my plans when I married Ned?
Marrying Ned and staying married to him are two entirely different things. You know, from the day Ned was born, everybody said he was the spitting image of me. And I am trouble.
Go over it again, George.
Oh, I've been over it a dozen times. You're worrying for nothing.
For nothing? I'm worrying because I'm afraid this deal might slip through my fingers at the last second.
Deals fall through for lots of reasons. We can't control all of them. But what I'm saying is that you don't have to worry that Julia's going to find out you're going to take over the cannery with a worker's proposal.
Well, you're awfully sure of yourself. You want to make a wager? Maybe you want to waive your fee if you're wrong.
Well, I don't think so. But we can hire another lawyer if you want. Oh. Look over this, that's okay.
No, I'm sorry, George. Maybe I'm getting a little paranoid.
You said it. I didn't.
It's just that I have no reason to trust Ned Ashton or Julia Barrett. They've both proven themselves to be a couple of snakes. They're both quite capable of pulling some low-life trick at the last second.
Right.
Well, hi, Jelly Bean. You're a little early, aren't you? Don't I even get a hello?
Going to Jenny's, but you're not going to let me go there either.
So how long have you been here, standing here, listening?
A while.
All right, go to Jenny's. We'll talk later.
Okay, Dad. Whatever you say, Dad.
Hey, this looks like Aerobic City to me.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, don't stop. I mean, not on our account.
No, stop.
Yeah, I don't want you to cramp up from lack of proper stretching after exercise.
Oh, I won't. I was just finishing.
Yeah, well, it's too bad. I wouldn't have minded standing here and watching you a while longer.
She's very good shape.
Yes, I can see that.
Mac?
Sorry, I mean, it's no harm in a guy noticing, right? After all, you have a figure that's hard to miss.
Just trying to give you a compliment.
Oh, that's what it is.
Yeah, he's just not too smooth about it.
Wait a minute, what are you talking about? I'm a smooth-speaking Scorpio, and you know it.
Well, I don't, and after your last remarks, I wouldn't even suspect it.
Oh, well, I guess we got to feel that way about it. I'll just keep all my compliments to myself.
Oh, that's okay. We know you're just trying to be nice.
Yeah, see? At least someone understands me.
I do. I mean, you're my uncle, which means you're my dad's brother, which means all the lame remarks you make are not actually your fault. They're genetic.
You see? She's got your number.
I give. I mean, I think I'm going to leave while I still have a little ego left.
No, wait. Before you guys leave, I got to tell you something.
What?
Don't get nervous now. It's not some parenting type decision or anything. I just wanted to tell you that I'm going to sign up for the volunteers at the hospital.
What's that?
Sort of like a candy striper.
Oh, well, that sounds very good. But how much time will it involve?
1 or 2 days a week, a couple hours, to help out at the hospital.
And maybe meet some male volunteers?
All right, exactly.
How can you guys question my altruistic motives?
Was I questioning? I thought I was agreeing with Holly.
With the boys or the volunteering?
Both.
Well, I'm glad you guys agree on my participation. I'll leave now before you guys change your mind. Bye, guys.
Bye. Careful.
Well, I think we pretty much agree on most things.
I think you're right, except about who's allowed to watch you stretch.
I don't mind you watching.
Well, maybe you should. I mean, after all, I am a warm-blooded male.
Meaning?
Meaning maybe you better keep those very, very shapely legs very well covered.
Why?
Nothing.
You don't have to worry. Ned and I are going to be fine once we get to know each other a little bit.
Good, but we're talking about the future, when the bloom is off the rose.
Does that ever have to happen?
You're going to have to keep Ned in line. Now, Lila has saved me for myself many, many times.
Oh, now, Edward, that's not entirely true. Mostly, but not entirely.
Good afternoon, Lila, hello. Dear.
Hi, Grandmother.
Hi, dear. Edward, I think I would like a few words with our Jenny.
Oh, good, good. Well, I'll leave you two lovely ladies to yourself. You see, you've saved me again, Lila.
Oh, get along with you.
Bye, Edward.
Now, Jenny, dear, we are both married to two headstrong, ambitious, stubborn men.
Well, I'm a little that way myself.
Oh, I am too, dear. But the great thing is, we must never let on.
So that's your secret.
Well, now it's our secret. And another thing, Jenny, never lose your spunk. That's very important. It's very, how is it you young people say, key?
Yes, that's right. Okay, I'll remember that. You know, unfortunately, I have to run, but I hope we get a chance to talk again soon.
Oh, we will, dear. We absolutely will.
Goodbye, Grandmother. Yeah.
Goodbye, dear. Bye-bye.
Jenny.
Hello.
Lucky to meet Nikki Langton.
Hi.
Jenny.
Hi.
Is my cousin Ned's new wife.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Congratulations on your marriage.
Oh, thank you. Langton, didn't I read about your father? Isn't he the one that was in the crash?
Yes. He's having some difficulty, but he's making progress.
Good. Good. I'm glad to hear that. Now, if you'll both excuse me, I'm afraid I have to run.
Sure.
Good seeing you, AJ.
It's always a pleasure, Jenny.
Mm-hmm.
They live in the gatehouse that we passed here from the river.
Wow. Well, that's a beautiful house. She's very lucky.
I'm not that lucky. She had to marry my cousin to get there.
You and Ned don't get along?
Well, let's just say we try to stay out of each other's way.
Why?
Business. He's obsessed with it.
The family business?
He eats, drinks, and sleeps ELQ Incorporated.
What does ELQ mean?
You don't know what... ELQ is Edward L. Quatermain, my grandfather.
Oh. Wow, well, your grandfather must have done really well with ELQ. I mean, I had no idea you lived in such beautiful surroundings.
You mean rich.
Yeah. I guess that's what I mean. I mean, I'm surprised that your mother and father even have to work.
Well, they don't have to. They love it. You know, doctors, they're dedicated to medicine, but sometimes they forget they have a family.
Well, they both seem very nice.
Well, nobody said they weren't nice. They're nice. They're just a tad forgetful. They put me and my brother in boarding school and forgot we were there.
Oops. Well, I guess that's where we share similar backgrounds, you know? You know, this is like a Kennedy compound or something.
Well, there are some differences, but there will be a lot of people here today. And if you'd like, I will introduce you to my very unique family.
Well, I'd like that very much. I mean, I'd love to know more about your mother and your father and your grandfather and even Ned. I mean, you're so exciting, AJ. I bet the rest of your family is, too.
Here you go, a free shamrock, courtesy of General Hospital. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye.
Dr. Hardy, here you are, your St. Patrick's Day tie.
Well, I didn't know you were Irish.
Well, of course I am. Everybody's Irish on St. Patrick's Day.
Well, I'll certainly wear the tie.
And don't forget the parade and the big party at Kelly's.
Well, I'm afraid I'm going to have to miss both. I'm on duty tonight in the ER. It's one of the busiest nights of the year.
Oh.
You know, too much drinking causes too many fights.
Yes.
And accidents.
That's true.
When you work in the ER, you begin to dread most holidays.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well. We'll miss you.
Bye.
I don't know why people would want to drink green beer anyway.
Neither do I.
We should all go down to Kelly's after work, okay? We're going there later.
Right? Oh, yeah, right. You'll be with Simpson. Amy, you'll be my date.
That's
oh,
right. Yeah, that's right. No. There are a lot of cute guys.
Ooh.
They go there every year and celebrate.
Cute guys. Uh-huh. Celebrate. Now, that has
we'll
a nice
be there.
Ring. Oh, yes.
We'll be there.
Yep, we will
bye.
Be
we'll
here.
We'll see you later.
We'll be there.
Okay, stay by. Stay. Dr.
Valfrey, what's wrong with you?
Nothing?
You're walking like John Wayne and nothing's wrong with you?
Oh, I'm a little bit sore from basketball practice. But don't you worry, because I am going to be busting a move with the best of them tonight.
Oh, so you are going to make it to Kelly's, right?
I wouldn't miss it.
Good.
And on the other hand...
Just the man I am looking for.
Is there a problem?
Yes, there is a problem. You have been working round the clock, and I want you to leave, take the afternoon and the evening off. I can handle everything here. It is St. Patrick's Day. I want you to celebrate.
Are you sure? I mean, I would hate to leave you alone here.
It's an order, Doctor.
Eric, I get off soon.
You heard the lady. I'm with you.
So, have Sheila give you a tie and go out and celebrate.
What about you? Do you want a little bow, Dr. Courtney?
I can pick one up myself. You get out of here before something does happen.
All right.
Okay.
There.
No, that's nice.
Yeah. Okay, so what was this?
You know, I read about the Jim Kelly basketball benefit for the children's board.
Yes, it's tomorrow. Doesn't it sound great?
It sounds wonderful. I was wondering, do you think you might need any help? Is there something I could do?
Oh, absolutely. We always need volunteers, you know.
No.
Are you interested in helping out in any other areas besides the benefit?
Yeah, sure.
Well, then, if you come by my office, I will show you the plans we have for our new children's cancer wing.
I hadn't heard anything about that.
Oh, well, if you have the time, I'll let you take a look at it.
Simone, I have all the time in the world. Right now, my life is on hold, so I am all yours.
Oh, well, that's wonderful.
Well, I didn't know you were coming by today.
Well, I was hoping
to
catch you. It's good.
We need
all
the help
we can
get. Holly!
Just a minute! Let's get in the shower.
Oh, have you seen that code deciphering book that Dominique gave me? I seem to have misplaced it.
No. Noriko must have put it away somewhere. Why'd you need it?
Well, I was going over the printouts of those nursery rhymes. I had an idea.
Another one?
Yeah, I did. I mean, I was thinking maybe there was a code word within the rhyme itself.
What do you mean?
Well, I can see a pin and pick it up. Maybe the word pin is synonymous for something.
You mean like, needle or sharp or something.
Exactly right, and I know there was a list of synonyms in that code book.
You know, you really should stop knocking yourself out over this. Bear in mind that Sean and the WSB are working on this. They have a lot more experience than we do.
I know, right, but not knowing is driving me crazy. I mean, I know that Pegasus came through the computer, and that's Robbie's code name. You read Sean, but I just think the Nanny Network is the clue to how Robert can find Anna.
Well, as soon as I've had my share, I'll come down and help you look for the book, okay? Oh, that's mine.
It's from Robert's attorney. Why is he writing you?
I didn't realize I'd left it down here. Thanks for finding it.
Those are divorce papers, aren't they?
Just let it drop, Meg, okay?
I'm a good listener.
I know you are. I'm just not ready to talk about it. Here's your book.
Bookcase.
Well, good luck with your adventures in cryptography. The sooner this whole thing is worked out, the better it'll be for all of us.
This time when our ship came in, we weren't at the airport. Oh.
True, very true. You two look as happy as an Irishman who just kissed the Blarney Stone.
Well, Ruby, this St. Patrick's Day, we have a lot of green to celebrate, and I mean money.
Now, Lucy, you're not going to hold out of me. You wouldn't do that.
We are all going to be filthy rich.
Me too?
You too. You know what I have in my little grubby hands here? I have A purchase order from Wyndham's for 2,000, read it, 2,000 bottles of Deception.
Lucy, you did it, you did it.
I sure did, and the orders are going to just pour in, all because of a wonderful promotional campaign I came up with.
There you go again. What is this? Why do you have to take credit for everything?
All right,
problem? Is that some sickness inside of you? I'm the idea man. I was my idea.
Ruby, I have a tiny confession. It was his idea, sort of.
Thank you.
Oh, and she gave you credit.
Well, she has to give me credit because she's the one that got us in this mess. I mean, Wyndham was looking for celebrities, you know? So I gave him local celebrities, like a local Barbra Streisand, a local Bette Midler, local Ann Margaret, you know? We had to sort of deceive WW2 there, and wins a war here, wants to take credit for everything.
I always knew you were the world's great con man, but I didn't think it'd come to anything. And don't
green
you
beer! Green beer! Green beer!
You hear
green
me?
Green beer!
You're going to be
beer,
so rich, you can't stand
beer,
it.
I better have you.
Okay, and if I am rich, then I don't have to do this.
Exactly, you don't have
beer,
to.
Don't get too excited here, you know. We have to deliver this perfume in 2 months, and right now we haven't got a single bottle of it.
That is the least of our worries. Stop it.
No, I'll tell you what, let's get out of here. We're going to go over and check on the plant, make sure everything's okay. I mean, if there's trouble, we should know right now.
Scott, don't you think that we could celebrate a little bit and worry about that later? This is all fine. You're worrying for nothing.
No, come with me.
Oh, stop it.
Amy, check out the sale over there.
Julie, you are right. There are very many handsome men here tonight.
All right. Let's go find a corner table where these two stock their
brains. Well, it really is a stud smorgasbord in here.
Hey, you don't be feasting around, or I'm going to put a muzzle on you.
Well, I can look at the menu as long as I dine at home.
Well, I'm thinking about that one over a beer. Two beers, please.
Okay, here we go.
My father was the first one there after the Philippine volcano exploded, and he helped all those poor people with their homes. You know, they lost all their homes. He was also the first one on the side of the big Mexico City earthquake.
Your father's raised a great deal of money, hasn't he?
Millions, yeah. I mean, he's spent his whole life traveling around the world helping the needy.
I'm always fascinated by a man who can charm millions out of the rich to give to the poor.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, and the same to you, dear.
I see we've got company. Nikki, have you met my father and my brother Jason?
We've had a most delightful visit. She's a very sweet girl.
It's good to see you again, Dr. Quartermain.
Nice to see you, too. I'm glad you took her advice and got out of the hospital. It seems like you've been living there for a month.
Well, my dad's all I have left, you know. But even he said I should get out for some fresh air today.
Well, Nikki, it's a pleasure to meet you, and I hope your father gets well soon.
Well, thank you. You know, Dr. Quartermain, your wife has done so much for my father. She's really an incredible doctor.
I agree. So do her colleagues.
She must have had the best training.
She went to Johns Hopkins.
Oh, that's in Washington, D.C. I love that city.
Yeah.
Did she spend a lot of time there?
Yes, she did, but that was before we met.
Oh, when was that?
It was a long time ago.
Dad, I hate to interrupt this, but we got to get to the hospital so I can sign up for volunteering.
Oh.
Hey, I'm impressed. Don't let me stop you.
Hey, listen, we're going to go to the St. Patrick's Day Parade afterward. You want to join us?
Well, I don't think we're in the mood for parade.
Oh, why not? Whatever you want to do, A.J., that's fine.
Well, Monica's covering for Dr. Simpson, so... Listen, why don't you join us at the parade and, you know, we can go to Kelly's
and afterwards. Well, that sounds like fun. You know, we'll go see the parade and then we'll go have a soda at Kelly's.
Sounds like a plan. Oh. Dad, you want to come with us?
No.
A lot of girls.
Celebrate here. Let the parade pass me by.
Okay, fine.
All right.
Maybe we'll see you at the parade. But if not, take it easy on the partying tonight, will you?
Thanks, Dad, for all the advice.
See you.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Mother.
Bye, darling.
Nice to meet you. See you.
Yeah, good. Good.
That you would have polished all those off by now.
Well, I have a little sore throat, but I'm going to finish every last one of them. I'm starving.
You want me to make you a sandwich or get a piece of fruit or something?
No, the cookies are just great.
Okay, well, I'm just happy to please my favorite nephew.
Your only nephew.
True.
Yeah.
And I am glad that you're here, but it's a surprise. How come?
Well... I was just making sure that you and Ned were taking me to the Jim Kelly basketball game.
Of course we're taking you.
Okay. Good. Because I want to ask Jim Kelly how it felt to lose the Super Bowl.
Oh, I'm sure that he had to feel badly. I mean, how else do you think you'd feel?
Miss me.
You know, I don't
know that you want to ask him that question. I mean, you wouldn't want to hurt his feelings, would you?
No.
Yeah, maybe you can think of something else you want to know. Something else you could ask him.
All right. I don't want to hurt his feelings.
Good. And I don't want you to worry, because we are not going to miss that game.
Good.
Sly, is there anything else on your mind?
I guess so.
Is it maybe something you want to talk about?
Well, ever since my dad and Julia split up, I don't know what to think about anything anymore.
What do you mean? Is that why you rode your bike all the way over here? I mean, you wanted to see if Ned and I are still together?
Yeah.
Oh, Sly. Couples, they break up sometimes. You know that.
Do you think you and Ned will ever break up?
I wouldn't have married Ned in the first place if I thought that we were going to break up. I plan on staying with him for the rest of my life.
I don't know. I bet my dad said the same thing to my mom.
What about Paul? You want to wait till he gets back before we finish this proposal?
No, he wants us to go ahead. His power of attorney is right there in that envelope.
Oh, yes. I have all I need. I can draw up the documents and get them over to Julie Barrett by tomorrow afternoon.
Good. Oh, good. Oh, this is so sweet, I can almost taste this.
Come in, it's open! Come in, people. We just put the finishing touches on the papers. We're set, we're ready. We are about to own a cannery.
Yeah, I don't think so, Bill.
What?
I'm sorry you went to all the trouble and the expense of the paperwork and stuff.
Marty, what? Don't drag this out.
I got some news from Miss Barrett earlier today. It's very unsettling.
What is the news?
And I don't want to be the one to break this.
Marty, be the one!
She's not going to go for our offer.
She's going with Ashton? I don't believe this.
Yeah, that's what she said.
I mean, how can she do this? Our bid was higher.
I don't know.
This doesn't make any sense. See, you mean she's gonna turn down an offer from her own employees and go with the Quartermains?
Yeah. Look, we are just upset about this as you are.
Upset? This is more than upset. This is betrayal.
I don't understand, Bill.
Wait, George. This is betrayal. The only way she would have turned down this offer is if she found out I was behind it.
We've kept this very hush-hush.
George! She found out! Somehow.
Well, I think I must have gotten him the perfect toy. He hasn't put it down once.
I thought I had an idea that would help Robert find Anna.
Well, I can see that this is a bad time. Why don't you give me a call later and we can talk, okay?
Oh, no, I don't want to do that. I'm really not making much progress with this.
Yeah. He's been at it for hours. He just mumbles things like words, rhymes, and synonyms. Come on, you deserve a break.
All right. You're both picking on me. You're right. Maybe I could use the fresh air.
Yeah, why don't we go outside? It's beautiful. Let's just go enjoy ourselves.
All right.
Go on, Meg. Dominique's right. Then I can tell you all my news about today.
That's a good idea. Maybe we can catch the St. Paddy's Day parade. How's that?
Oh, could we? I love parades.
Sure, Holly, want to come along? It'll be fun.
Actually, no, I've got an awful lot of things here to do. And, besides, you two deserve some time alone together. It might be ancient history, but I do remember what it's like to be in love. So go ahead, go on, enjoy yourselves.
All right. Thank you, Holly.
Thanks.
Go get your coat.
All right.
You've got a very special man there.
I know.
Hey, come on, let's go.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Cy, there are lots of reasons that people break up.
Why do you think my dad and Julia did?
I don't know.
Well, I mean, you're a sister. He had to tell you something.
Your father can be a very private person when he wants to be.
Well, what about Julia? She's your friend, too.
Sly, Julia and I are friendly. I mean, I wouldn't call us close friends.
Well, then what do you think?
I thought they had some difficult times. And Julia's father was part of the cartel, and your dad was trying to fight it.
Yeah, but they made up after that. That's not it.
I know. It's hard to understand. Sometimes people change. For lots of reasons. Or when you're very close to someone, maybe you start to see things that you don't like. That can cause problems.
I don't understand. It's so confusing.
I know. I guess we both just don't know why they broke up. But I do know one thing.
What's that?
Your dad loves you. And that is not ever going to change.
I don't like him that much right now.
Well, you're going to feel differently. Remember that your dad's hurting a lot, too, over this breakup.
Well, I think he's just being mean to me.
Oh, no, Sly. He's very good at hiding his feelings, especially when he's hurt. I promise he is not being mean to you on purpose. You just give him some time. You'd want him to do the same for you.
Yeah. Okay.
Look, can I give you a ride home?
I like to ride my bike, Fizzery.
That's fine.
Okay.
Hey, you think about what I said, okay?
All right.
Thanks for coming by.
Ride safe.
Okay. Bye, sweetie.
Robin and Jason are signing up to be volunteers.
Hey,
terrific. Wow, isn't that wonderful? Well, this just seems to be the day for signing up volunteers for the hospital.
Oh, really? Hey,
Jason, if I'm correct, you had talked about following in your parents' footsteps, right?
Yes, I would hopefully like to be a doctor.
And he will be, too, I'm sure. He's a very determined young man. But at the moment, what we need are more volunteers, so I think I better put some posters up on the bulletin boards in the hospital.
No, wait, yeah. I think Robin and I can help recruit some kids from the high school.
Oh, really?
Oh, I didn't think you would remember me.
Didn't you two come together?
No, we just met here.
Of course I remember you, Robin. I make it a point to know all the class presidents.
Well, we can speak to the rest of them and maybe talk at the assembly.
Sounds like a plan. Mm-hmm. Good luck with your recruiting. Shall we? See you later. Mm-hmm.
How about you meeting me in my office in about 10 minutes?
Okay.
Okay.
See you there. All right, so, let's see, do you know John Dangood, the sophomore class president?
Yeah, I do.
All right, so why don't you talk to him, and I'll talk to Alice Newman, the junior class president,
why don't we talk to them both? That way it's more of a team effort.
Good idea.
Jason seems to be helping Robin with the volunteer program.
Well, at least we made out with one son.
Don't give up on AJ yet. Oh, by the way, I saw him earlier on. He was at the house with Nikki Langton. His choice of friends is better, that's for sure.
It was. I saw Nikki earlier. She didn't say anything about being at the house.
Maybe it slipped her mind.
Isn't she a little old for AJ? A
couple of years, but I don't really think that matters. Listen, she's very well-traveled and has a good family background.
Yeah, maybe so. Maybe I'm just trying to recover from the Nancy Eckert fiasco.
I don't think this is anything like that. I mean, Nikki might be a good influence on him.
Oh, I don't think it would last very long with Nikki.
Hey, Monica, they're friends. They're not getting married.
Well, it was okay. I mean, the kids had fun, but I'm not really into parades.
Well, I know that my family was really impressed with you.
Really?
You know why?
No.
Because you're smart and you're beautiful.
Thanks, AJ. There's a dance to hook up.
Sure.
Do you want to dance,
you? You
I dance all night.
I'm like, no, I'm shocked.
No, but I can follow anything. Lead on.
Watch it.
Just want to get a look at that tie.
Yeah, where's your tennis racket there, AJ?
Have you ever noticed how some girls have all the luck?
Amy, girl, you just listen to me. You make your own luck. Now, there's plenty of guys out there. Go find one.
Do I have
you? You go to? Absolutely. Go on. Go on. Go for
get him, Amy.
Good girl.
No, there isn't a problem with the divorce papers. No, I do understand everything. It's just, that I don't think it's really urgent that I sign them. You know, Mr. Scorpio is away at the moment, and... Oh, yes, as soon as he gets back, I'll take care of it. Good. Okay, well, thank you very much. Goodbye.
Well, this Valentine thing looks very promising.
Well, hi.
Hi.
Oh, I'm glad that volunteering for hospital work is putting you in such a good mood. By any chance, was my prediction correct? Were there a lot of cute guys there?
Oh, I did meet some.
And was it a boy?
Well, he's almost a man. He's really cool.
What's his name?
His name's Jason Quartermain.
Oh, Alan's son.
Yeah. Oh, we signed up together and we're going to try to get other kids from our school to join, too.
Well, I'm very glad you enjoyed yourself.
There's kind of this party at Kelly's, you know, because it's St. Patrick's Day, and I kind of had a feeling Jason might be there. I was wondering if you want to go, or girls night out?
Well, I think I could get myself up for that.
Oh, cool. But I gotta change first.
Why? You look great.
Where do you see me in this?
Oh, well, we'd better throw it all out then. And...
Come on, stop making fun of me.
I'm not. I'm just teasing you a little bit. So, just to explain one thing. What happened to poor old Roger?
Oh, I'm still seeing Roger. Oh. I just think Jason's cute. He probably thinks I'm just a kid anyway.
Sounds like a bit of a crush.
It's not a crush. Oh. I just think he's rad, that's all. It's not like I'm in love.
No, of course not, of course not. So, I'm going to change, too. Okay. And, okay. Let's go.
Yeah.
And, I think a bit of the green would be appropriate. What did you say?
Do you absorb the information better that way? Does it all just sort of fall off the page right into your deeper consciousness?
I'm doing my homework.
Yeah, that's a pretty cool technique.
Dad, I have to finish this.
The whole book? By tomorrow?
No, just this page.
Oh.
Okay. What?
What? You're pretty angry with me these days, aren't you? I think we should talk about it.
You're angry with me, too.
What's wrong, Jelly Bean?
It's nothing.
It's something. You're pretty upset because I don't want you to hang out with Miss Barrett, right?
Yeah.
Well, maybe I made a mistake. Maybe you're a better judge of who your real friends are than I am. I'm cool about it now. If you wanna see her.
Yeah, Jenny thinks that you were hurting as much as I was, with you splitting up with Julia.
Does she?
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah. It hurts whenever you argue or fight with some person that you've cared about.
So are you mad at me?
No, I think I was mad at myself, and I just took it out on you.
Do you think you and Julia will ever get back together?
No, I don't think so.
I really like her.
I know. I'm sorry about that. It's, Well, see, sometimes these things, they just don't work out, you know.
Makes me sad.
Slicer, I want you to know that no matter what happens between me and any woman, now or in the future, I'll always love you. And even when we don't understand each other, we have to stick together and try and work it out. Because we're all we got. Truth, little man?
Yeah.
Oh, good, good, good. I feel so much better.
How about a burger and a shake at Kelly's to celebrate?
Cool.
Cool? Like moderately cool or like really cool or like quasi cool or like... Like
really cool.
Really cool. Good. Let's go. We're out of here. Hang on. Did you warm up the car? Maybe I'll let you drive.
Well, here you go. You two look like you just lost your best friend.
You know we don't have any friends, Ruby.
I hope it's not the perfume empire.
Perish the thought. It's just that we're tired because the jig is up. I mean, we've been doing the jig all day today.
And we don't look like you enjoyed it for a moment. Scotty, don't screw up on this one.
Oh, I'm not, Ruby. The ship has come in. I mean, I see it. It's this big seven-masted schooner, and it's there, and it's not leaking.
Uh-huh. Well, I'll try to see it.
Sit. Now, will you please just cheer up? It's a minor setback. Now, come on, smile, or I swear I'll pull your nose.
I have been smiling this whole time. It's not just... it's hard for me to be optimistic. This is just a little setback.
Okay, listen. We have the formula. All we have to do is find another manufacturing plant. That's all.
That's like saying we have rocket fuel, but we don't know the way to the moon.
Ew, I will send you to the moon anytime you want to go. Now, I will get us out of this mess. I promise.
Hey, how come you're not wearing any greens? How do you...
I am. You're just not looking close enough.
No, I'm not. You know, I think that maybe we should dance right on out of here.
Oh, you do, do you?
Yeah, well, look at our roommates. They're occupado, and the apartment is empty.
Right.
For you.
What are you looking at?
Oh, Dr. Simpson and that nurse.
Yeah, I know. What a dweeb, huh?
Really, you know, that was my impression of her, too.
Why are you so interested in Simpson?
Well, I'm not interested in him, but he is my father's doctor.
Yeah. Forget about him. Let's dance. Come on, we have a great night ahead of us.
I enjoyed the parade more. That was so great.
How about that sheepdog dressed as a leprechaun?
Oh, no, no, no. The guy in the four-leaf clover suit. I think
that was a riot.
Yeah,
exactly.
I think so. You know what?
What?
With all this excitement, I have forgotten to tell you my news.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Well, I went over to see Simone at General Hospital today, and I'm going to be doing volunteer work and donating some money to the Children's Cancer Ward.
That sounds like very important work, Dominique. That's great. Look at you. It's great to see you so excited about something.
Oh, I know. I can't even wait to get started. I'm just... There's so many things I want to do.
Right.
I think that...
Let's not be unfriendly now. It's a holiday.
Absolutely right. Enjoy the holiday, guys.
Yeah. Hey, listen to him. He talks with a funny accent.
How about you, lady? Do you talk funny, too?
Look, yeah. Why don't you leave the lady alone, all right?
Aw, come on. She's too pretty to be kept by you. We want to hear if she talks
too
funny,
pretty.
Too.
Listen, why don't you just keep going before you get in over your heads? What do you say?
Oh, come on.
Hey, come on. You don't want to do this. Hey. I'm telling you, you don't want to do this, all right?
Hey, we were just having a little fun. I mean, you don't have to get so soft.
Hey. Well, not at the lady's expense. Just go on, fellas. Have a good time. It's somewhere else.
Say, St. Patrick.
Gee. Good God.
You okay?
Do you know that you are my hero?
Wasn't much of a fight.
Nah, you're still my hero anyway. You always have been.
Heroes don't exist, Dominique. I don't want to be anybody's hero. wait a minute. Wait. Maybe. Maybe we should go someplace a little more private.
No. I think I want to continue walking. I'm okay.
Well, we've got all evening. I'm sure Holly and Enrico can take care of Robin this evening.
You know, I've been thinking. I'm really impressed by Holly. She's a very strong woman. I don't know how I'd act if I were in her position.
Well, Holly is quite a lady. You're my girlfriend. Don't you forget it.
How can I? You keep saving my life.
Goes it?
Well, it's a period of adjustment, you know.
Any word from Robert?
Robin seems to be holding up pretty well.
Yes, and she met her potential new beau today. Schoolgirl crush.
Oh, no, according to Robin, no.
I think they're trying to figure out that.
I'll give it back.
Thank you.
Thank you.